Greetings.
Greetings.
My name is Asta Black.
Yeah, man, I know who you are.
You know?
Yeah.
And your name? For Jamie. The audience.
Okay, my name is Jamie Ann Chavans. I'm the youth outreach officer at NIA.
What's your last name?
Chavans.
Is it related to the most popular person, Rastaman? Dr. Chavans?
So we have had discussions about that, so yeah. He has said yes, but you know.
Good man.
Very
good man. We miss him a lot in the Rasta family.
Okay.
Yeah. NIA, what is it?
NIA stands for National Integrity Action. We are a civil society organization. We are NGO, actually. Mm-hmm. So we are not-for-profit. That our main mandate is combat corruption and build integrity in Jamaica.
Yes.
Right, so we do that in various ways. One, we lobby for anti-corruption legislation. We try to build the capacity of our justice sector officials. And we also build awareness among the public, community groups, youth, so forth.
Dr. Monroe is part of it?
Professor Monroe, yes. He's the executive director. Our executive director, and he is in charge and directs the day-to-day running of NIA.
You know of his early days in politics?
Somewhat, yes. I heard
he was a communist.
Yes, he was. At the time, it was thought of to be the most popular way to go, and the ideology that would, change us for the better at that point in time.
Would we say that's a form of socialism to get more social structure into our community of Jamaica?
Well, I'm not certain. I won't go on.
Not say. On his say, not his part, but as our part now. What do you think about socializing our government in Jamaica? We're imploring young people to be more assertive in building Jamaica. Jamaica first.
Right.
Like, yes.
Right.
So isn't that
and to become more involved and engaged in what it is that happens. I think one of them, I can't say if communism is the best route or whatever, but what I can say is that we need our young persons to get more involved and to feel that they have the ability to signal change within the society.
Yeah, man.
And that is where we're lacking. And so what we have been doing is training them and showing them that over the years, Jamaican youths have been able to engender change.
Yes. Yeah. And only them can do it because they have some of them are brighter than our elected officials, but they're not asserting themselves, they're not putting themselves forward. Are they being trained to look a job?
Well, I can only talk about the training that we do is in keeping with NIA's mandate, which is to build their capacity at issues of governance and to call out for good governance, right? So in terms of looking at job and things, that is not within our mandate. So I'm not certain if it is being done elsewhere. Yeah. But I know that in terms of our training, that is what we do. And we're trying to build groups of young people, which is what we're doing with the Integrity Action Movement, and trying to get Integrity Ambassadors programs within high schools.
What do you think about community television? Do you think it's reaching the people? Because you're in national television.
In comparison to TVJ and CBM? I think for the most part, I will tune in to some of those channels because some of the programs that they show are specific to the community. And you'll find that individuals tend to look at them. I can't tell you the impact that they are having or to what extent persons are watching it, but I am sure that once these programs are dealing with issues that the community finds relevant to them and that they can partake in those discussions, that it would be something that they will look towards.
Yeah. BobArtsTV is a community channel seen in Trelawney, St. James, Hanover, Westmoreland, St. Elizabeth, Manchester, and then Illinois, Indiana, because we are more tourism and we are community-based.
Okay.
Can you come and work with us in some of our communities?
Well, no, that's not a problem. In fact, that
you
we would
no?
be... No, I said no, it's not a problem. We would actually love to do that because that's one of the things that we're aiming to do. Go into communities and to see how far we can get them to come together, yes, and build and make platforms for them to speak out and say to their representatives, this is what we want, this is what we find,
yes,
that is more poignant to us, yes, in terms of what we need to make our community better.
Thanks.
So that, most, amen, certainly.
Thanks for talking to us on Bob Arts Television.
Thank you for having me.
All right. Tell us your name again.
Jamie Ann Shabazz.
How can we reach you?
Okay, you can call me at 906-4371 at NIA's office. Or you can go on our website at niajamaica.org. There is a place there where you can send us an email and we will respond right away.
Sweet.
Facebook as well.
Yeah, man. NIAjamaica.org.
Right.
We're there. See you, man. Blessed love. Thanks for talking to us again.
Thank you for having
Respect.
Me.
Yeah. More coming. Mr. Mayor.
Yes.
Oh, I go on.
Well, you don't know where to go. Yeah.
Young people are born a fire upon the politicians, so you don't give them the platform to move forward.
No, you know, well, they have some concerns, and their concerns are valid. Mm-hmm. And I think it is full time for politicians, those who don't give young people enough time, need to step up to the plate. But I am not one such politician.
Yes, yes.
I have given maximum attention to young people.
Mm-hmm.
And if you go into my division and my constituency that I'm seeking to represent, you will get that. I don't ignore. But the young people, they too have an obligation.
Yeah, man, they need to step up.
They need to step up, it's true, they need to get involved.
Yeah.
Right?
I am wondering why.
We can't alone take all the blame.
It's true.
They must accept some of the blame. Because the thing about it, Ross, any one of these young people you check, them not getting themselves au fait with the current affairs in Jamaica.
True.
They're all on Facebook, nothing wrong with that. Then they're on Instagram, nothing wrong with that. Right? Then they're on WhatsApp, then they're on whatever.
Mm-hmm.
They need to be taken up with what is happening in their country.
And Facebook, Instagram, all the social network is a way to market. They don't realize that they sing a song and they put it up on Facebook and sell one song in every town in the world, they'll be a millionaire.
Perfect.
Why
perfect.
Just sit and WhatsApp? Perfect. What are you doing
some
now?
Some of them use the network for the wrong reason.
They don't,
and Mr. Shura Gribbs says it.
Seen.
Right? You make comments on your Facebook page will come to haunt you.
You're looking for a job.
Years down the line, when you're looking for a job.
Even becoming a representative in your community, and the people in the community look at your social network and see a whole heap of tattoo all over the place, your pants to the ground, earring in the nose.
Listen, man.
You have to represent yourself first. Market yourself first.
Responsibility.
Yes.
I know that a lot of them, they are challenged out there.
Yeah.
Because a lot of them, their own parents has abandoned them.
Yeah.
And at 14, 15, they have to be fighting life on their own.
Yes.
And it's not easy.
Why can't the government put internet in every community center right across your
division? Well, that is happening now. Because yesterday, we were in Welcome Hall.
Yeah.
We're the Minister of Energy, Science and Technology.
Yes.
Handed over $4 million worth of computer to the Welcome Hall Community Center up in South St. James.
Yeah.
We will be moving now to have another...
Where is in Welcome Hall? Welcome Hall is the community center.
Little above Kensington on your left hand there.
Okay, that's Kensington.
Yeah, there was a big ceremony there yesterday.
Yeah.
I was there as a mayor.
Bobar's Television is seen in those areas.
Yes.
And I don't know anybody. It wasn't widely promoted.
That is so true because let me tell you.
Yeah.
And I'm going to cause some people to be upset. I wasn't even invited as a mayor.
Yeah.
The councillor for the area wasn't even invited.
So who is running things? Right? Kingston?
No, it's not Kingston. It's the directive that was sent from down here to Kingston. It was the minister's office that caused me to say, how can something like this be happening? And I don't see your name as a mayor for the city of Montego Bay. Who have spoken to me about the importance of getting this project done?
what is your position in the St. James Municipal Department? What is your position in there?
My position in terms, you mean, I am the mayor.
Yeah, but yes. For Montego Bay, is it the mayor for St. James?
No, you are the mayor for the city.
Of Montego Bay. What is right. What is your other function?
My other function, I am councillor
yes.
for the Cambridge Division.
Yes.
I am the constituency caretaker for Southern St. James.
Yes.
I am a deputy general secretary in the Jamaica Labour Party.
Yes. And then
yes.
you're also the manager for the municipal department, right? Or
yes.
the CEO
yeah.
or what?
No, I'm not the CEO.
You're the manager?
I am the mayor with responsibility.
Yeah.
For the running of the St. James Municipal Corporation.
All right. Now,
the buck stops with me.
Exactly. Now, when you give out work, for example, the road from Derek Kellyer to Ed Barclay to Malahu Fort Road going to Kensington, were you there in Kensington a couple of days ago? Were
yeah, I was there yesterday, and the road is in a terrible state. There's no doubt.
You noticed that.
I spoke to the member of parliament.
A pothole was fixed here, and right beside it, another pothole is still not fixed.
I've seen some clarifying.
Yeah, but
taking
Mr. Mayor,
place
Mr.
with
Mayor.
A view to have those things
yeah,
patched.
Mr. Mayor, did anybody go back and review the work and see if payment should be made?
Russ, I'm not even sure if the work is done.
Okay.
Right? If the work is completed, that's
uh-huh.
it. Right?
Yes.
But what I do know is that, and it is NWA
yes.
who is supervising the doing of that work.
True. So should the NWA let you know who have the contract to do that?
But I can know who's the contract.
Yeah.
I can know who's the contract.
How much is paid and how much is spent
yes,
and all
yes,
that.
Yes.
Because
that information, you can
confused.
Get it. You know?
Yeah.
You can get it as someone who's from the media.
Yes, yes.
Right? You can
go. Where do we start? NWA?
You can speak to NWA.
Okay.
Just tell them that you see a patching program taking place on the Springfield
yes.
Kensington Main Road. You'd like to know who is the contractor.
Yes.
You'd like to know the sum of money that is being spent.
Mm-hmm.
It is no private business of anyone.
Anymore.
It is no private business.
Cool.
You can go there, identify yourself as a community leader and say, listen, I am making this inquiry.
Yes.
Because I need to know.
Yeah, because the road must stay good. And
no,
I drive that all it every day. And we hear people calling
yeah.
in on the radio mm-hmm. about that. So how are you doing in council? How is Mobie? Mobie nice?
Mobie is nice. And you know some of the problems that we are having with the crime and stuff like that.
Yeah.
It was Thursday, I met with the vendors on St. James Street and downtown Montego Bay. And we started a discussion. And I must tell you, it is a very healthy and positive discussion.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm hoping that within a few months' time, the street, St. James Street, will be free of vending.
Oh, yeah?
Yes.
Yeah, man.
We are having discussions.
What are we going to do with those
people? Remember, you know, those people are business people.
Yeah, man.
They are contributing to the economy.
Yes.
We cannot cart them away and carry them to St. Elizabeth.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Sorry, we cannot push them off of the street like they are nobody.
True, true.
They have children going to school.
Yeah, man.
They have children going to high school.
Yes.
They have
college
bills to pay. They have
yeah.
mortgage to pay.
Yeah, man.
Right?
So
we have to find a way and work with these people.
Mm-hmm.
As I said to them, I am going to give you a space. I need a space. And the traditional business people, they themselves need their
taxes,
space.
They're paying taxes.
Right?
Man.
Yeah. They are paying taxes,
they
are paying
rent,
everything.
They, pay
they are employing people.
Yeah.
Right?
Yes.
So everybody
have to coexist.
Have to coexist. Because if you get them off the street, what can arise from that, it might not be the best for
true.
Montego Bay.
Yes.
So
yes.
I start
first
the dialogue.
How long may stop your friends that walk through this?
Right, I start the dialogue, and I intend to continue the dialogue because I need to see the city return to a state where people can walk freely. Right, where people can walk freely,
yes.
where the sidewalk is not clustered,
yes.
and we are getting there. As I said, I met with nearly 200 vendors in the council's chamber Thursday afternoon.
The discussion was very fruitful. You know what I mentioned, very the former mayor, you should make the street, the St. James Street, in the middle. And on either side of the sidewalk is like cobblestones with eateries and theater and everything along that. Because right now everybody drive in the middle and it's not like two lanes anymore. So what do you think?
Well, we thought about it is that we will be dealing with some of those issues. And I'm not sure we can go to where you had suggested.
Yes.
Because Montego Bay in and itself has really outgrown.
True.
The place, yeah,
man, yes.
Right?
So we need to move the commerce outside of St. James Street.
Well, it has been happening, you know.
Night time, it's a total
view.
Yeah.
Look at Fairview, out by Hope Village.
True.
Out by Westgate is getting busy now. Yeah. Overton. All the shopping centers that has been built in the last 30, 40 years. They have all
CC for life.
CC for life.
Zamir. Yeah. Is one of your councillor, or is your MP?
Was your boss?
Well,
we have promoted him to the higher house.
Is your boss now?
Yeah, I'm a boss now.
Yes.
I'm a boss now. He's a member of parliament for the St. James Municipal Corporation.
So
any problem we have, no call upon him.
We sent him up there.
You sent him up
there? Yeah, because I call him college. He's doing a good job.
He's a CC boy.
We love him, man.
A good boy. A good boy.
Latest thing he helped us with. Stabilizing our electricity up at school. But you respect for that man.
Second,
I see that everybody, the young people, want to see you more, want to know how you can offer them a platform to build a career.
You know, dialogue, as I just say, that you dialogue as best as possible to come up with the ideas to move forward. So I'm always ready to be advocated to and for. Or on behalf.
Thank you very much, Lamia.
And therefore, I continue to accept the youngsters then, because you know, even in our association, a youth we deal with.
Yes.
And therefore, I will always, at all times, and embrace them, because it is Jesus Christ who says, suffer the little ones to come.
Come unto me.
I want the little ones to come unto me and for us to discuss.
Yeah, and as Rastafari, our thing is for youth be cared for.
Yes.
What do you think holding back the young people? Because they have social network, they have tools, they have computer today.
We are too much of an individualistic country and people.
Mm-hmm.
We need to embrace more. We need to go back to that time when we pass a person on the road and we say, good morning, welcome, good afternoon.
Where your granny used to
once we get there, then we have just opened the door to be unified.
You always say that your grandmother
say. Yeah, and that's a part of my grandmother saying.
Exactly. Are we missing the grandmothers?
We are missing the grandmothers, and in this instant, the grandmothers is really the community.
Yes.
Until we get back to the where the community was a part of everybody that lives, everyone that lives within that community lives.
Yes.
Then we're not getting anywhere.
True.
We just don't be our brother's keeper when we go to go defend a man.
Mm-hmm.
We must be our brother's keeper to say to the same man, you are wrong in doing certain things, or this is the approach, and I want to hold your hand and walk with you.
In your community centers, in your constituency, are you promoting internet?
We are promoting internet. I have just brought to Kingston through the assistance of USF, Universal Service Fund, 5 applications to create contact centers within the community so that nobody will be able to say that they can't get on Google or they can't surf the internet.
Yes.
Trying as best as possible. Even in Canterbury, we have one.
Nice.
And we are looking forward to have one in Albion Lane. Roseite has, Farmite has. We want to go into Flower Hill, Salt Spring. Mm-hmm. Salt Spring has one at the Baptist Church. We want to go into Melbourne. One of the problems, one of the setback though, is really in our space to host the situation.
Now, if you know the idea of computer labs is outdated, you know that.
Yes.
So to put internet in certain places.
Well,
is a waste
right now
of
the
time.
Minister just last week, the minister announced what he called Wi-Fi town centers.
Yes.
He has established 4 already, one in Mandeville, one in in Grand, Sir Grand William and so on.
Yes.
And he is rolling out as much as possible. So yes, in short order, you're going to see those in Montego Bay.
Now, where all the centers that you have established in your constituency can now use Wi-Fi to distribute to their the homes around. So,
yes.
So all they need to do now is some IT person, young people with IT ideas and technology skills.
USF is working on internships.
Yes, send out your things. Yes. Hey, man. Keep up the good work.
All right, my brother.
All right. CC for life.
Peace. Success.
Success. Don't go nowhere. Enough more coming. Stand up. Stand up. Greetings.
Stand up for your
right.
Here
something
Zuba.
Going on?
It's just that, I mean, over the years we have been hearing the same responses.
What is your name?
My name is Khalees Allen. And
what country are you from?
I'm from West Central. My MP is Marlene Malone Ford.
Yes.
I'm a student at the University of the West Indies, a law student.
You're a law student?
Yes.
Yes.
And what I'm seeing is that Khalees Allen.
Okay.
What I'm seeing today is that Jamaicans are not as informed as we used to. We're supposed to be. Many of them who come here today are asking questions to these MPs or a member of parliament, and the responses that they're getting is not necessarily sufficient, but it's just that they don't have the requisite knowledge they need to challenge these MPs. And as Jamaicans, I think that not just we aren't just supposed to be depending on our head of state, we're supposed to be depending on ourselves, trying to get the requisite knowledge that we need, whether reading books, going to seminars,
you're saying then you're blaming your young people
because
ignorance is no excuse of the law.
Yes.
And as a law student, you know that.
I know that for sure, and I'm seeing it today.
Yeah, you know, Haile Selassie said you should never be caught without something reading.
Yes.
And that's my king. And one of the heaviest politicians ever to walk the earth. Now, what are you as young people doing? You one of Donald Trump's favorite word is America first. What are you doing about Jamaica? Is it Jamaica first?
You know, it should be Jamaica first. And Jamaica is not just what we see on TV or head of state or representative. Jamaica is our citizens, the people that actually aid
what
in
are
the
you
development.
Doing? What are you
as
doing?
Youth, I must say, I'm a member of G2K.
Yeah.
I am also an active member
G2K?
In my Young Jamaica Area 4 Council that comprises of Montego Bay and neighboring parishes.
What affiliation to what political party is that?
My affiliation is to the Jamaica Labour Party. We're not really, at the moment, we're not really.
Can you vote?
Loyal to them, but I mean, we're just here to. Any avenue that we can access to make a change, that's what we're doing.
Okay.
So we're not necessarily tied to that Labour Party.
You didn't sign anything?
No.
Okay. So why did you choose the Jamaica Labour Party Youth Arm or not the PNP Youth Arm?
All right. So this is a testimony. Just now, less than an hour ago, somebody from the PNP side came to me and to ask if I wanted to join their body.
Yeah.
I was like, for me, first come, first serve.
Same.
We're just looking for an avenue, not necessarily having favored one, but looking for one. So that's one of the reasons why I'm not on that side.
So do you think if you were an independent-minded person, you could have done more research and find out a better way to go than...
And we have tried that, and this goes back to the government again. It's like
the government.
As an independent person, it takes a lot of risk and it takes a lot of resources. And as a student of the law.
What do you need the resources? Why?
I mean, to get the information out there. It's not just
but
in
we have
James,
internet
but
though.
You
have
internet
and you have WhatsApp. You use
we
WhatsApp?
Internet. We have WhatsApp. I'm not really a social media person.
Well, why not? That's the way of life today.
It's not the way of life. No. I personally don't think we make it the way
of
life.
Well, Barack Obama used it to become the president.
Yes, he did.
Yeah, so why you don't think it's the way of life?
I just think that there should be a shift. There should be a shift in our mindset. And personally,
can you shift your peers' mind?
Through lobby and campaign. I mean, Jamaicans, once you are that charismatic person, we have seen it with Vybz Kartel.
Once you're that charismatic person, you can make a change. A change is possible.
So do you think young people still have the vibes, cartel vibes? Yeah. You think so?
I think he's still here, and they still have to an extent, but we're seeing where we have a shift now to the alkaline.
Mr. Chung.
This young lady is a nationalist, but I don't want to influence her wrongly. I'm going to be one of the future leaders of the country. Though.
She is a part of the young Jamaica Labour Party. She is.
All right.
But she's wondering, why aren't you setting the platform for her to excel? That's why she's wondering.
No. What does she need to excel? I'll help her.
Is it... Dr. Chang is she's asking you what you need.
West Central, but I help all
students. Dr. Chang is asking
she
you what you need.
She is from West Central, San Diego, but I help anybody in San Diego.
Well, I've seen it. Personally, I would say, is it because I'm engaged in a field that is quite, it carries a quite hefty fund? I mean, law. We have, when you look at the scholarships that are accessible to us, you see, not really accessible to us, let me change that. You see, excluding law students can't get this, law students can't get that.
Do you
we don't want to just go to our MPs. We want persons.
What would you want your MP to do? What would you want your MP? It's what you can do for your country.
You don't want MP, because MP, they can help. I help all students and Zedians.
Yes.
Come to my office.
No,
I have two bachelor's university. It's a whole heap.
Dr. Chan. You're part, your youth development, your job development, job creation for Jamaica. How are you going about doing that?
It's a broad policy. The 3 years we're working on is still traditional areas, agriculture, business services, and of course trading activity with the port activity developing, which can employ 100,000 people. Other things fall in
Push on through. All right, that's the chance. All right, Lord, in Jamaica. Run away all the time, man. You got like respect.
Lord, I've got to keep on.
Here for the whole session?
Yeah.
Live on Bob Arts Television.
Yeah.
What do you think about it?
Well, I think it's a wonderful session for the youths them especially, you know, because what happened is it's important that the youths have a platform to express themselves.
Yeah. But do you think they have it?
Well, this program Talk of Youths definitely is a great platform.
Before this Talk of Youths, you think that it was there all along? Like, we have social network now, we have multimedia. Do you think these kids are being trained to work for somebody, or they should be developing their own jobs, their own skills?
Well, two questions you asked. Let me say, the first thing, I believe in order for the platform to be available for people, young people to express themselves, it's important that somebody has to organize the whole structure, the event.
Yes.
So the organization of it is important. And this is what Talk of Youth does. Secondly, to what the next thing you asked, what we have is young people who are passionate about various things, different job types, descriptions, and whatever. I mean, I don't think society should try to force them into areas that they're not comfortable in, because that is counterproductive to what the country could
really. Are they being forced?
Sometimes, yeah, especially because of economic pressure. When you think about it, somebody who really wants to be a veterinarian, has to do something else because the finances, you know, sometimes not available to push them in that direction.
Okay, but if you're served, if you have a lime, you have to make limeade. you can't make milkshake with lime. So how do you create something using the lime? Do you expect somebody to force you to create something with the lime, or should you be creating something?
No, well, you're absolutely right. I mean, the thing is, you have to use the tools that you're given to create the opportunities that you really choose for yourself.
Yeah, man.
You know? So I believe that this is one of the forums, one of the platforms that is helping to
you learn something from it?
Yeah, man, definitely.
Yes,
so that the youth them can definitely, you know, create their own opportunities.
So what do you do?
I'm a musician, I'm a singer.
Singer?
Yeah,
so,
man.
Do you think the government have a role in how you market yourself?
Well, definitely. I mean, I have some involvement in certain rehabilitation programs.
What's your
and
name?
Stuff like. My name is Jawiz.
Jawiz.
Yeah,
respect.
Yeah, right. Man, respect.
You're going to be Empress.
All right.
How you doing, man?
You're going?
20 how much?
28.
And you're a PNP?
Yes.
Why you choose PNP?
I chose PNP for its ideological foundations and the intellectual capacity, the evidence intellectual capacity of its leadership, which I'm not saying the JLP does not have capacity, but I'm saying that I identify more with the People's National Party and the roster of youngsters and the cadre that we have who would be the second tier leadership and the third tier leadership of the party.
Why did they lose the election? Why? That tough?
You know,
tell my viewers your name again.
Your viewers are here. I'm Ashley Ann Foster. I am chairman for St. James Central. And you're asking why we lost the election.
Yeah.
We have all heard there's a report out crafted by the Julian Robinson Committee.
The Russians.
Which speaks to our loss at the polls, and I think it is a very comprehensive document, and that is better to speak to it than I am.
Okay, cool. But PNP lost and JLP in power now. How do we work together to make Jamaica, like I love Donald Trump saying America first. Should we be thinking Jamaica first?
We need to place ourselves first in many facets. However, we belong not only to CARICOM, but to the international community. So here at home, we need to ensure that we are best placed within that international market to succeed and to garner the business and the economic growth that we need to progress as a society and as a nation.
I heard you're born a fire upon Dr. Chan about ganja thing.
Yes.
You think he's ill-informed, or too old, or not keeping up with the time?
I think Dr. Chang has only one perspective with regard to ganja, and that it has negative effects when it is smoked. Nobody can dispute that with regard to the fact that with some people who smoke it for their personal use, there can be negative effects.
See.
However, in other markets, specifically in the United States and Canada, when you look to a Colorado or a California,
Uruguay,
ganja or cannabis, Uruguay, for medicinal purposes, is a large booster for those economies. And there is no reason why we should not explore medical marijuana. There have been licenses issued for that exploration.
Here in Jamaica. Do you think the wide scale issuing of license is because of all the people that we owe money to the International Monetary Fund, the multinationals, and all of these people, they're saying that do not legalize it, or else our pharmaceutical companies such as Bayer or Pfizer Laboratories, all of them will be losing business if ganja become the cure.
Boy.
And we have the cure here. You think that's where, because Dr. Chang is a doctor of synthetic drugs.
That is one school of thought.
Yeah.
However, I don't have any conclusive evidence, and I would not like to think that is why, we have taken.
Well, we hear that Monsanto and all
the
of those
steps
people.
Forward. But we have taken some steps forward, and we need to see them through.
Yeah.
And we need to also ensure that when these licenses are granted, that the people on the ground benefit from this cannabis business, whether they are subcontractors or sub-growers, whatever it is, the structures need to be put in place.
PNP and JLP was in the parliament in 1963 when atrocities and Rastafari took place right here in St. James, where the Chamber of Commerce was the one to write the Queen and say we are here trying to topple our government. Now, not just the JLP, but the PNP and civil society were there. Couldn't someone stop the massacre on Rastafari? Why the PNP didn't stop it? I know they're the ones who are saying that a JLP killed an arm.
Well, I wasn't there, so I can't speak to it firsthand.
You believe in slavery?
But ideally, no, I don't believe in slavery. I don't believe
in any...
Well,
you weren't there. Do you,
I don't
would you
believe
advocate?
In any form of oppression.
Would you advocate against slavery?
I said
slavery?
I was not there,
all right, go on.
So I cannot give you a firsthand response with
all right,
regard
but
to who responded.
The Prime Minister apologized.
The Prime Minister has no apologized.
Yes.
The apology is a little bit dated.
Do you think the PNP should apologize also?
For not intervening?
For not stopping the killing, yes.
We could make an apology for...
We could,
for we, okay, fine. I understand how you feel.
So
we should...
will you apologize now to the Rastafari?
We are very sorry. Big up yourself, Rastafari.
Yeah, true, man. Ganja. Do you think because we have been murdered and killed and everything, go to prison for one split life, people in prison for a long time for one split?
Yes, we made sure to decriminalize that and expunge those records, though.
Yes,
as a party.
True. Are you the
party?
Your party
my party.
True. A JLP follow it.
Right.
Yeah, true, man.
It's called adoption.
All right. That's good. Continuation of what is good.
Right.
Hey, man. Your name again?
My name is Ashley Ann Foster.
How can people reach you? Because the young people, I'm saying, they want you to come in their community and build the party.
Oh, the people can reach me at my law practice at the Montego Freeport Shopping Center.
Yeah. You know what happened to me personally?
Tell me.
We got permission to develop a school at the Trelawney Stadium, which is a reggae in the sun, and the young people will come and learn different areas of the arts. And the Honorable slowly kicked me out. And now the JLP is in power. And they say, come back and do the thing. Excuse me. The JLP come in power and say, come back and the GM called me up and said, come and do the thing. It was a good thing.
What so, kind of school is it?
It's an arts. It's a school for the arts, all areas of the arts. So what I did, I had to like light the candle and find a way, you know. Because these are the kind of things that politics do, is stop progression and... That's the kind of thing that I think I see politics do. They don't support. If you're not part of that, they cut you down.
Well, if that is so, it is extremely unfortunate.
Yeah.
And I'm glad that you have gotten the opportunity to follow your dream and to empower people through the arts. It's a very necessary thing.
Yeah, man. I'd love for you to come and speak to our students.
I would love to come and speak to
you. Respect.
Them.
Thanks, man.
Thank
I always
you.
Wanted to meet you.
And I always want to meet you.
Yeah, please. Don't go nowhere. Enough more coming. Asta Black Live with Empress.
All right.
Mala Empress.
Ashley.
Ashley.
I said, hey, ain't no giving in. Rastafari never leave. So even when the road get rocky, my son will never give up. I said there ain't no giving in. And when the going get tough, I said the tough get going. My people don't give up.
So I go on.
Good.
Everything blessed.
So far, how is it?
Good. Right. Yeah, man. Your father and I go way back, you know, man.
We know that, man.
We're bridging.
We know.
Yes,
I know
yeah.
the link.
Nice. Young people. I'm sorry you didn't make it on time to listen to them.
Yes.
Should they be thinking Jamaica first now?
Well, let me tell you. Even if they want to say, put themselves first, it is smart to say Jamaica first.
Mm-hmm.
Because Jamaica is theirs.
Yes.
Jamaica is ours. So whether you want to think individually or think of Jamaica as a group,
mm-hmm.
we own it. We are responsible for it. And so we have to think about how we're going to protect it, nurture it, and advance it.
True.
A big part of that means that we have to give young people a voice. We have to give them also a platform to be involved. And we have to give them an opportunity.
Why aren't you giving them?
Well, I tell you this. The government is trying.
Your father...
But we have much more
been,
work to do.
Yeah, your father has been there for a long time
yes.
in politics. And the people, the young people are still calling out for that platform.
Well, I tell you this, young people will always call out for it.
Yeah.
And they should.
Yeah.
But truth be told, we have much more work to do. And that's one of the reasons why I'm involved.
2017.
To try and see if we can transform the process and advance it to a place where it's more result-oriented.
Yes.
So you would hear us talking about building out programs that are not just social programs, but more active programs to get people involved in mentoring and volunteerism and to give support and engagement to these kind of things like Talk of Youth. Mm-hmm. And come as ministers. Dr. Chang is here, I am here. Even though the rain stopped me, I still came out of the helicopter and drive, come on, I am here. Yeah. Because it's important to first and foremost engage, educate, and then empower the youth. Mm-hmm. And so once we are starting that process, which we have started, we now have to look on the infrastructure and the institutional framework for them to be involved.
Yes.
And so we have national mentorship programs that are being built out now. We have the CSJP. We have other programs.
What is CSJP?
CSJP is the program in the Ministry of National Security, Citizen Security and Justice Program, that gives vulnerable youth an opportunity to become involved in vocational training and get a stipend.
Yes.
You would have heard about the Prime Minister's LEGS program, which is Learn, Earn, Give and Save.
I'm glad you're saying it now, because do you think it reached communities like Maroon Town, Garlands, Kensington?
If they are aware of it?
Yeah.
No, I can't say that they are aware or not aware. I've never been there. No, meaning you asked me a question. I say to you, I can't answer for them.
Okay.
What I can tell you is that we have used every medium possible to reach out to them. And so even this medium, talking to a man like you, who have your footprint every single place,
true.
I hope that's another way that we can reach and communicate to the youth, to say to them, there are opportunities. Go on the websites, read the newspapers, try and get yourself educated.
And this is what I would love to see, the Universal Service Fund taking internet into communities in the hills, because some of the students can go to school 3 or 4 days a week and then the money run out till the paycheck come in Friday evening to start again.
And I think that's a worthwhile idea,
yes,
actually.
And I think the Ministry of Security should be working with the Ministry of Technology to work together as getting these things happening, because it's not about community computer labs anymore. Those things are outdated. I don't know why we're packing up computers in one building and expect the children to leave them home. And as a Minister of Security, you're not going to let your daughter walk, go down the road, go to an internet cafe, and then lose time. My son and I, when he was little, we were in Columbus, Ohio, playing Pac-Man at the airport, and the plane left me.
Yeah.
So can you imagine a child now on his internet?
No, let me tell you.
They're not leaving it. Night come and they have to go home.
I get the drift of where you're going. Okay. And let me support Wi-Fi. It and tell you further. At the Ministry of National Security, we actually have a Stay Alert application.
Yes.
Which we're inviting all of Jamaica and all of your listeners and viewers to download. If you have an Apple or an Android phone, go on.
But you need internet for that.
No, you don't. You once you download it, you do not need to have internet
connectivity,
minutes or connectivity on your phone. Once you have the smartphone, it is one of those websites or applications that we have worked out a deal with the providers that you can use even if you don't have any money on your phone.
Oh, nice, fantastic. Right? So, that's a great idea.
Yes, and it gives you the opportunity to now use it as a panic alert system to contact the police. You can record information and send to the police. You can learn about the law. And you can also receive alerts. So when somebody is missing, it comes up on that program.
I have to go get my mother. My mother has a little regular phone where she used to.
The banger.
With the light on top.
No. You have to change up the phone for your mother.
So therefore, educate my mother, 87-year-old mom, to use smartphone.
And I tell you something, many of our old persons in Jamaica have significant knowledge about technology.
True.
My mother owns a nursing home.
So
we deal with elderly people consistently. Mm. And every single one of them have smartphones.
Yes.
Your mother's the only one with a banger right now, so you have to change it up.
We step up in their life. Yeah. Can you give everyone watching now, we're a local community channel, we're seeing in Trelawney, St. James, Hanover, Westmoreland, St. Elizabeth, Manchester, and then we touch Illinois and Indiana. So what we love...
So you're not local, you're a local international.
Well, you know, because we're in the tourism capital, yes. So we use our channel also to bring more people to our capital. Can you tell people watching us now that website where they can go on their smartphone? And
well, you use your smartphone and you go to your applications,
yes,
and you download the Stay Alert application.
Fantastic. Yes.
Right? And it's fabulous. It is your opportunity to have on your own phone your own panic alert system.
Yes, yes.
For free.
Yes.
The government covers that cost for you.
And, you know, we see crime seeping into little communities. Mm-hmm. And if people are afraid to report, so
this is an anonymous way.
Fantastic.
Right? This is an anonymous way to report the information. The only thing is, if you want to be able to press the panic button,
yes,
you have to put in some information so that the police can know
where
you
right
are and get your geolocation.
Yes. Yes,
but
yes.
Besides that, if you have information to send, you can send it anonymously. Yes, yes.
And they won't be able to trace it back to you.
No, man.
Fantastic. Yeah. And that's what the people want to know, that when they report something, it don't come back because the person who they talk about will come and harass them.
Well, I tell you this, but we also need to move ourselves to a place where we, as the administration and the police force, do enough to build back that confidence and trust.
Yes,
because
yes.
People should not be afraid to talk to us.
Yes, yes.
Right? And so, that is something that we are focused on. So you would have heard the introduction of polygraphing in the recruitment process.
Yes, yeah, that's so right? Cool,
and,
man.
And all of these things are really for us to be able to
filter out the bad apples.
Filter it up, because it's in everything. It's not just the police force.
No,
every organization has good and bad.
Yes.
And so we want to maximize the potential of the good and strengthen our ability to create a connection with the people.
Mm-hmm.
Because I tell you this, without the people, nothing will succeed. We could get every single gun, car, boat, bulletproof vest that we want.
Yeah.
If tomorrow we got all the money and bought everything that the police force needs, if we don't have a connection with the people,
it's
nothing. Why? Yeah. The people provide intelligence.
Yes.
The people provide guidance.
Yeah,
and the people are the ones that are going to be needed as witnesses for you to carry out a prosecution.
Yeah.
They are integral to every process.
Should we see district constable now taking up a job? Not the job, but to be more functioning within communities, go play a domino, listen to stories and so on. We don't see the function of the DCs.
It is something to think about.
Yeah.
I don't know that I would tell a DC that he has to go and play dominoes, but I think a DC should take upon himself the understanding that it is important to be a participant in your community activity.
Yeah. Yes.
And so if you want to be an effective police or district constable, it only makes sense for you to integrate with your people so that they feel comfortable and confident in you.
Mm-hmm.
That is what we are here. That's why I'm here now.
Should the DC be a public figure, knowing that everybody know he is the DC? Or should we have some private investigators undercover and things like that? Because
the concept of the district constable is a public one.
Yes.
If you have a separate concept relating to persons who are acting covertly, then that wouldn't be a district constable.
True.
That would be somebody who's acting undercover.
True.
And I tell you this, we need a balance between both.
Yes.
Because the undercover person is effective in getting information that wouldn't readily come to us.
Yeah.
While the district constable is effective in treating with situations that normally happen in normal daily life.
Yes, yes.
So both are needed at the same time.
Young people again now want jobs. They want to grow. They want to be able to be effective in their livelihood. Now, musically, should the Ministry of Security work with individuals to create more arts education?
Well, we're doing that right now.
Sweet.
So you know that I'm responsible for correctional institutions.
Mm-hmm.
And so within the correctional services, what I'm doing is we're working with the Ministry of Culture to put together a musical compilation of persons who have been in our system, who have come out of our system, as a means of
Vibes Cartel.
No.
Lisa Hanna.
I'm not going to say Vibes Cartel and Lisa Hanna. Okay. But I tell you this, I'm not against anybody, including Vibes Cartel, if it is positive, getting an opportunity to be rehabilitated through music. I don't see why we are stymieing any human being's progress.
True.
All of us can fall short of glory.
Yes.
And all of us are deserving of some kind of assistance to be lifted back up.
Yes, yes.
So I'm not going to put a stamp on any man because...
And young people is really gravitating to Vibes Cartel, and the more have things popping up, the more people are going to gravitate to it.
Young people gravitate to whatever is
positive,
hot at the moment.
Yes, yes, true.
Right? I mean, we did too. Back in the day,
and
I remember going to Sting and Bounty and Beanie and Bob Marley. So that's not to be feared. We mustn't fear change. Right? What we must do is embrace it and try and understand.
Yes.
Right? And give people an opportunity for them to become positive contributors. So, as I said to you before, we're using music as a means of rehabilitation, and I think it is a magnificent rehabilitative tool. We're going to continue to do so.
Mm-hmm. So we now developing an arts education. Is there any way we can contact your ministry to see how you can?
I tell you this, for all the persons who want to contact me directly,
yeah,
I am on Facebook. You go to Honorable Pernell Charles Jr. HON. Pernell Charles Jr. and just shoot a message.
See.
And so my staff will get it and we'll be able to contact you, set up an appointment if needs be, or set up some kind of, identify whoever is most relevant to whatever it is you want to do.
True.
And we get it going. We want to create platforms for persons to get involved.
Okay. What do you think about community television?
I think community television is important because it drills down to the issues and allows persons to have that one-on-one, localized kind of communication. And so, Jamaica for long, we've had community television in different places.
Yes.
Maybe not as many as we need.
Yes.
But I think people like you,
true,
you're carrying the mantle.
Yes, yes.
And we need other persons who can pick up, because what you do know is you provide a platform for me.
Yes.
I would never get an opportunity to speak to you and to speak to everybody that's seeing me now, right? But now I have an opportunity for them to listen to me and to say, boy, minister, I'm so like him have little sense, or I'm so like him have no sense, whichever.
True.
But at least now they can make an impression.
Yes.
They can draw their own impression.
And what you've said about the app and all is so relevant.
Communication.
And they need to do it. So yes, what you've said to us here on BobArts Television is really relevant, and we thank you very much for talking to us live.
Yes, man.
And community
all channels. The best to all of your viewers. Big up Ras Asta. Big up community television. Keep on doing what you're doing.
Yes.
It's been years.
Yeah, true.
And I know you're not going to stop.
Yeah, no, I can't stop. I yell up your dad.
Yeah, man. Bless up.
Respect. All right. More coming.
Who knows? Who knows? Who knows? Who knows? I just go where the trade wind blows. Sending love to my friends and foes. And I suppose.